good day, everybody. Just as we did last time when we had a look at the comparison and contrast of some vowel sounds, we now want to go to consonant sounds. We want to look at some consonant sounds and compare them and contrast them. Now, the first set we are going to look at are so and zo. So, zo. Don't forget, I said so is a voiceless consonant sound, while zo is a voiced consonant sound. I want to look at some of the words on the chalkboard, how each of them is pronounced, and with the transcription written in front of each of the words. We have price with the transcription, and we have prize. We have rice. We have rise. We have raise. We have raise. We have advice. We have advise. Look at this advice. Now, some people say advice. So, if you check your dictionary, there is nothing like advice. But we have advice, the one with, and then we have advise. And that's why I have tried to put the stress sign there. Stress sign. If it's advice, if it were to be advice, then it's going to stay here. But that is not it. So if you check your dictionary, you see the stress is before V. Before V for the first one, before V for the second one. Again, this advice is noun. Why advise is a verb. So please take note of that. We have advice, yeah, we have advise. We have device, we have devise. We have lies, we have lies. Now, I also said in one of our past lessons that when a word ends with a vowel sound and it takes plural marker S or suffix S, that S changes to Z or Z. Now, the same goes for a word that ends with a voiced consonant sound, as we shall soon later. Now, when a consonant sound ends a word and it takes plural marker S or suffix S, as you may call it, then that S changes to Z. Alright, we have mice, we have miser, we have stops, we have dreams. You know, why is this one stops? Because consonant P is voiceless and consonant M is voiced. And each of them takes plural marker S. And that's why this one remains so. Why this one is zo? Simply because this M, which is a consonant sound, voiced one, is voiced. And therefore, the S here changes to Z. Now, listen very well. A student asks a question. The student says, why is it that STOPS is transcribed stops? Why is it S here? And DREAMS is transcribed dreams. Why is Z here? Why not SS? Because it is S here, it is S here. The simple reason is that when a word ends with a voiceless consonant sound, don't forget I said we have 9 voiceless consonant sounds and 15 voiced consonant sounds. One of those 9 voiceless consonant sounds is P, P, P. And when it ends a word like this and it takes plural marker S, or what some people call suffix S, that S remains so. That's why you have so there, so, the conventional letter S. But it is not the same thing when the word ends with a voiced consonant sound, as we have it here, one of the 15 voiced consonant sounds. And when this situation arises, then, and it takes S, That's voice consonants and takes S. That S automatically changes to Z. And that's why you have Z. It's not only this. We can have P-I-G-S. Pigs. That S is, it turns to Z because G is voiced. Now, like another one, we say rubber. Rubber. And it takes S. That S changes to Z simply because ro is voiced. So that is it. When it is a voiced consonant sound, sound that has a word and it takes plural marker S or suffix S, that S automatically changes to Z. But if it is a voiceless one, like k, like po, like t, like so, like fo, and some others, and it takes plural marker S, that S remains so. So we are going to the next set of our comparison of consonant sounds. And the next set is the dental fricative, where the tip of your tongue touches your upper teeth. That's TH. TH for the first one, TH for the second one. But take note, the first one is voiceless, while the second one is voiced. Now let's look at the word. Bath. See the transcription. Bathe. See the transcription. Cloth. Description is there. Then clothes. The transcription is there. Breath. The transcription is there. Breathe. The transcription is there. Loathe. The transcription is there. Loathe. Loathe. The transcription is there. Then we have thought. This thought. Then do. Now, when you look at each of these voiced ones, you'll discover that it is thicker somehow than the voiceless one. Just as I said in the first set, we also have strengths here. We have strengths because the TH there in strength is voiceless and it takes S. Therefore, you have strengths when it is transcribes strengths. But close, because I said when a voiceless consonant has a word and it takes suffix S, that S changes to Z, or when a vowel sound, as we have it here, hence a word and it takes S, that S turns to Z or Z, and that is exactly why we have ZO there. This one is ZO, this one is ZO. I want to go to another set. Voiceless, dental fricative, and t. Both of them are voiceless. You remember? They are voiceless consonant sounds. But they are not pronounced the same way. Through, true, thin, tin, thread, tread, three, tree, bath, bat, and some others like that, which you can check in your textbook and the dictionary. We want to quickly go to another one. So we are at another set. Voiced consonant sound. Another voiced consonant sound. Don't forget, this one is TH word. And of course, the other one is D. This one is TH, TH, TH. This one is D. We have THEN, THEN, THEN. We have THEN, THEN, THEN. We have LOATH, LOATH, LOATH. We have LOAD, LOAD, LOAD. We have BREATHE, breathe, breathe. Whereas here we have a breed, 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 sorry. Breathe, breed, mother, mother, mother. We have mother, we have mother, mother. We have side, side, side here. Then we have side, we have side. We have ladder, 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 and we have ladder, ladder, ladder. So those are the two sounds compared here. Now, when we were having a look at the consonant sounds, and we came across this consonant sound, I told you that it's somehow very difficult, or a bit difficult, for non-native speakers of English language. And it is here, here, here. Now we have trail, trail, trail here. And you have pressure, pressure. This one, you remember, represents SH. Pressure, 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 trail, pressure. Then we have vision, vision, like television. Then you have fission, 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 fission. They don't sound alike. This vision, vision, television, occasion, mirage, espionage, camouflage, garage, and some other words as you find it, find them in your notes. Then this one is fission, fission, fission. As we have sure, as we have sugar, as we have charade, as we have chagrin, as we have chaplain, champagne, rather, champagne. It's a type of beer. So please take note. They don't have the same sound. This is representing SH, while this one is J, J. So this one, we want to go to the next set, which is the last that I will treat here. This one is J. This one is J. Don't forget your letter A, B, C. We have letter J. But J has no space here. It has no place here at all. So we have J, J, and J, J. So we have bridge. This bridge, bridge. You have beige, beige, beige. Bridge, beige. You have badge, badge, badge. Then we have barrage, barrage, barrage. So these are the consonants that you want to compare and contrast this time around. You are welcome to our class for today. We have rhymes. Rhymes. You must have heard that word before. Rhymes. Rhyme is defined as a word that has the same sound or ends with the same sound as another word. It occurs in lines of poetry in literature and English, as well as in the English language, paper 3. It is a section and the WAEC conducted West African Senior Secondary Certificate Examination. It should be noted, however, that the issue here is not concerned with spellings or meanings of words, but rather with the sound of the words. Especially at the ends of such words. Examples of rhyming words include blame, proclaim. We'll give you more examples very shortly. More examples. There are so many, and you have to take note of them. Now we want to see more examples of rhyming words. We have return, we have burn. We have rain, rain, rain. We have hide, ride. We have tomb, room. We have shout, about. We have mine, nine. We have key, key. Look at this spelling of the first key. Q-U-A-Y. That's key. The second one to K-E-Y. They have the same pronunciation, they have the same transcription, but have different meanings. Different meanings. Key, key. We have gate, we have great. We have tour, we have poor. We have leather, we have rather. We have allowed and crowd. Ow, ow. We have most, we have almost. We have court, we have salt. We have mountain, we have fountain. Foul, foul. Terror, error. Detain, obtain. Burn, horn. Home, roam. Flower, flower. Loins, coins. Letter, waiter. Diction, fiction. Nam, plan. Don't forget, I said when we were treating the consonant sounds that when a word like this, N-U-M-B, is written, the B is silent, meaning you are going to have nam, nam. And the other one, you have plam. You know, remember I told you that plam, we have plama, not plumber. So, the same thing here, nam, plam. Then catch, match. Now, these are the last examples I will give you on rhymes or rhyming words. Mime, rhyme, amend, depend, end, shook, cook, hike, spike, pad, mad, heard, shared, there, bear, conceive, achieve. Ballet, chalet, relish, blemish, labor, neighbor, kill, feel, soul, and soul. So these are examples of rhyming words. Normally, when you have a rhyme word, the last sound rhyme with the last sound of another word. Labor, neighbor. Kill, few. So, so. Mime, rhyme. Is the last sound of the word. So that's when rhyme comes in. So thank you very much.